So good morning, everyone. So before I start, I'd like to thank the organizers for giving me the opportunity to present the CMB Bharat talk in this meeting. So I'm going to talk about CMB Bharat proposal, its current status, and the forecasting result that we are currently doing within this consortium. So my name is Duhin Ghosh. So I'm giving this talk on the behalf of the CMB Bharat consortium, which is an Indian cosmology community. So what is CMB Bharat proposal, or what is the need of next CMB mission? So CMB measurements have transformation for cosmology, and the Planck mission, which was launched in 2009, it extracted almost 100% of the CMB temperature information. So the measurement of temperature is cosmic gradient limited, but only a small fraction of rich polarization, CMB polarization information was extracted. And since Kobe, there was no additional information extracted on CMB spectral information. So there are a lot to explore in the CMB polarization side. So that's why as a various group, they are proposing a next CMB mission to have extract like 100% information about the CMB polarization. So there are a lot of scientific promise for this next CMB mission. So some are categorized into ultra-high, which reveals the signature of primordial gabrielian waves. So if you can detect R, we can get handle on inflation. But then there are some high-end goals, like neutrino physics or mapping the dark matter distribution of the observable universe using the lensing potential. So these are guaranteed goals that we can get using the next CMB mission. Also, we can get legacy dataset. So there will be improvement in cosmological model estimation by factor of 10 million. And also we can get extra galactic and galactic astrophysics dataset like the Planck. And also there are unexpected discovery space. So if you have a spectrometer, which can extract the, we can measure the CMB absolute level, we can get unique proof for entire thermal history of the universe, which goes up to 2 × 10⁶. So the next CMB missions are broadly classified into two groups. So they are targeting either B modes or spectral distortion. And so these are some names of experiments which are proposed, like CORE, PICO, ECHO, PIXI, PRISM. So some of the experiments are have low resolution. So they're targeting primarily at larger scales, or some experiments are targeting high resolution. And like PIXI, it can do both, like spectral distortion B-board or the PISA. So, hello. Okay. So B-mode is, so the ECHO is a, another synonym of like proposal. So the community is CMB Bharat, and the experiment name is ECHO, which is Exploring Cosmic History and Origin. So just to give you the context, so the CORE mission was proposed to European Space Agency, but it did not pass the initial programmatic screening in by ESA in January 2019, but it got very high science rating by the committee, and it get a support from member states, but the cost does not fit into M-class envelope. So they suggested to seek international partners. So this was in January 2017, and the first discussion happened to have Indian participant in June 2017. And the CORE proposal PI and co-PI, they meet with ISRO, SPO. So they are like chairperson of ISRO in October 2017 to explore if we can have joint collaboration prospects. So the talks get started after this meeting, and in January 2018, so we collect all the Indian community and see if we can take up this thing, or if there are enough interest in the Indian community. So we had a meeting with ISRO chairperson in the headquarter, and there was two outcome of that. So there was a possibility to launch ISRO-ESA joint study, and CMB Bharat consortium was formally made after that meeting. So it has 90 members from 15 different institutions and is still going. So based on the discussion, we asked to submit a proposal, which is announcement of opportunity as the next step. And the proposal was submitted in April 2018. And the first presentation was made in June. So there was like a lot of proposals were submitted. And the CMB Bharat mission was shortlisted for presentation to the advanced group in ISRO, or like advisory committee, in December 2018. So the goal of the CMB Bharat mission is to have near ultimate CMB polarization survey. So it will observe the sky in frequency band between say 28 to 850 gigahertz. So it will cover the low frequency band and high frequency band to effectively clean the foregrounds and get the CMB. So it has two configurations. So one has a noise sensitivity of 1 micro K arc minute, micro K per arc minute. Another was 2 micro K arc minute. So when it was first discussed, so we can have onboard absolute BB calibrator. So the idea was to have a survey for 4 years, and then it can work with 2 years of observatory mode. So there were new science cases which are listed here, which can be detected. There are improvement about the previous finding by Planck, like cosmic anomalies, skeletal clusters, and high precision standard model parameters. And also we can do a lot of complementary science like cosmic infrared background study, or measuring the magnetic field and the dust in the Milky Way, and also detect possibly detect magnetic dipole emission. So when this proposal was written, it was explicitly envisaged international collaboration. So it's not that India is alone is doing that. And CMB Bharat mission design and technical specification builds on several mature design already proposed elsewhere. So in particular, CORE and PIXI. So the PI of CORE and PIXI are listed in the international point of contact in the proposal. So this is the noise sensitivity of ECO. So this is better than, slightly better than Lightbird, and it also goes to high L. So Lightbird resolution is 30 arc minute, and this can go up to like 1 arc minute. So it's basically we can extract high-L information from ECO. So this dotted line is for sensitivity of the temperature, and the dashed line is for polarization. And to just compare it, we also plot the existing Planck mission sensitivity. So it is way better than Planck. Okay, so there is a high-end, ultra-high-end dividend from the measurement of CMB polarization. So one of them is detection of primordial gravitational waves or skeletal tensor issue. And the target sensitivity of ECO or CMB Bharat mission is to detect R of 10 to minus 3 at 3 sigma detection. So this is currently the constraint on R from Planck with low TEV and latency. And the idea is to constrain this R to an accuracy of, like if it is 10 to minus 3, we can detect this. And to show that we can do it, so in the proposal, it is, this plot is taken from the proposal that we can do better or better detection with internal delancing, or either with CMB latching potential or CIB extracted from the ECO. So ECO has like high resolution, so it can extract CIB itself, and it can be used to use for delensing purpose. Also, there are high dividends. We can do a lot of neutrino science. So we can constrain neutrino mass, the running of spectral index, DNS by DK, tau, lensing potential. So there are a lot of guarantee science we can do with this mission. Also, there are a lot of astrophysical data set, like Planck says that. So we can do the same with CMB Bharat mission. So here I'm listing few of them. So, like we can make high resolution map of CO line emission map, or we can study the galaxy formation through cosmic infrared background anisotropy map. Also to study the spectral dependence of the dust emission, if you have a lot of treatments, spectral coverage. And through polarization, we can see like how the magnetic field goes in the small scale. So with Planck, where we can do it at very large scale with the lower noise level, we can see how the radio magnetic field varies over the smaller scales. So when it was proposed with two configuration. One is like taking the whole frequency bands, and we add three extra high frequency channels, 700 to 900 gigahertz channels. So this is mostly to study galactic signs or to extract information about the dust, thermal dust emission. So this has a 2400 detectors, and the sensitivity was for correlation sensitivity was like 2 microkelvin per arcminute. So later on, it was another configuration was proposed, which goes to a lower frequency band, so up to 28 gigahertz, and it stops at 850 gigahertz. And so it has a lot more detectors, so it's around 6,800 detectors. And with this configuration, we can achieve a sensitivity of 1 micro K arcminute. So for the forecast result that I'm going to show you is mostly based on this advanced configuration. So the CMB Bharat, the total is like 1.5 meter diameter configuration. So the total mass is like 2 tons, and it fits into the launch capability of GSLV Mark III to launch to the Sun or Earth L2 orbit. And so this is like a ISRO spacecraft, which can take CMB Bharat to the L2 point. And it already launched Chandrayaan 2, so it's a mission to Moon. So it has a orbiter and a lander, which was launched in July 2019. So this capability is there in ISRO to launch and they also have some interest to launch to L2 orbit. So Indian technical contributions. So these capabilities that are challenging, but nevertheless, it can be achieved in India. Some of the total project. So some of this is like listed here. So like mission planning and operation, and launch to L2 orbit, tracking, control, orbit maintenance, science, data download, term link, service module, and also we can contribute to the extensive modeling of instruments for calibrating systematic effects and data products, simulation, analysis, and science. So in ISRO, with modest planned investment, they can take up the telescope and optics. So there is a laboratory of electro-optic system, or LEOs, which is part of ISRO, and they are showed interest to construct the telescope and optics, which are listed here. But then there are other parts to it also. So the last meeting happened with Space Application Center, ISRO, in May 10, 2019. So CMB Bharat provides an opportunity for Indian laboratories to launch long-term technology development in key areas of interest to ISRO. So one of the part which can be taken up by the Space Application Center is broadband photon noise emitted sensors and readout for CMB frequency bands. So in that meeting, this headquarter, SAC, they already have funding to for the detector detector development program to set up a telescope, a 3 meter dish with this much funding at Himalayan site. So that site is very good for CMB observations. So that this was a bit old slide, and now it is they are doing it with Harvard and setting up like 6 meter dish there. So they are interested in this technology development thing, which we need to merge or align them with the proposed CMB mission so that they can take up this part of the instruments, and it will be good for CMB mission. It is also benefits the medium and long-term strategic investment. So built upon the capability of India, ISRO, we can have enhanced the experimental effort in academic institution in India. And also there are different parts like quantum sensor technology, which are used for this kind of mission, can be used for other part of research, like other fields of research in astronomy, or even in quantum computing. So the idea is to develop labs and test infrastructure which can be used for training young scientists and engineers for long term. So this was the status in 2019. So we had a exploratory meetings with the expert for different CMB, next generation CMB experiments. So we met in Bangalore in January 2019. And from the ISRO, the science and technology experts, they also came. And the meeting was very fruitful. And we also had a meeting with terahertz detector technology workshop at SAC Ahmedabad. So based on this and our submitted proposal, the ISRO chair, they set up an inter-center team. So this committee was set up to see what are the technical dividend for future ASTRO proposals, primary like CMB Bharat. So they made this committee to see if they can be benefited from the technical dividend. And also in ISRO, they tried to channelize some of the work to academia. So there are different institutes, academic institutes in India, like ICERS and IIT. They are taking, basically they're seeing if they can take up some of the load. So we identify our teams in different institutes, which can either work on nanofabrication or space cryogenics. Okay. So in the next part of the talk, I discuss about the forecasting results that we are doing with CMB Bharat, under the CMB Bharat consortium. So when we wrote the proposal, we did not have much time to do the analysis and see like whether we can really achieve this sensitivity of 10 to the minus 3 at 3 sigma detection or not in presence of photons. So we do a thorough analysis here. In this work to see if we can achieve the required sensitivity or not. So we take the advanced configuration, which has 20 frequency channels covering from 28 to 850 gigahertz and with polarization sensitivity of 1 μK per minute. And we also allow for delays. So these are the frequency bands listed here. These are the different beams, frequency dependent beams and the monitor. So this work was done by a small set of people in under the consortium. So it's mostly led by the PhD student at IUPA and Aparajita Sen from, she's also a PhD student. And we also have Jack Gillaby in the team to give a session about foreground modeling. So these are the different foreground model we consider. So mostly we consider two foregrounds, which are thermal dust and synchrotron. So for thermal dust, I think the main problem is the dust decorrelation with the current component separation method works, including dust decorrelation or not. So we considered a model where there is no dust decorrelation. So simple generic dust model with modified black body spectrum derived by Planck. And we also considered two set of models. One is based on H1 template. So it naturally produces decorrelation in the model. And the giant's dust model, which is constructed from dust extinction map. And also for synchrotron, we take 30 gigahertz template, derived template from SMICA as a template, and then we vary the spectral loss from power law to curve power law and Gell-Kropff model. And we also include in some of the models, we include spinning dust and point sources and not taken into fitting routine. So we use two methods mostly. One is Commander and one is NIRC. So basically in this, so we take very simple foreground model and try to go into complicated foreground model and see at what level it breaks down and at what confidence we can recover our desired sensitivity. So here are the model listed here. So there are 4, 6, 9, 11 models. And we apply, these are full sky simulations. So we apply both Commander and NILC. So Commander, we take the publicly available version of the Commander, which is Commander 1. And these are the model of dust and synchrotron. And we try to play around with different configuration where we include AME and point sources, but not fit in the Commander framework, Neatlet is a blind open suppression method, so it does not matter. So it does not need to be specially taken into account. We also considered delensing, or like with 84% delensing. So with core, it was shown that with internal delensing and CIB, we can achieve 70% delensing. So here we take optimistic limit of 84%. And then we start doing a more complicated model of dust. So this giant dust and PD dust is with including dust decorrelation and seeing where this current algorithms fits. So what we do is it's very simple. So we take R is equal to zero. So assuming there is no primordial gravitational waves, we take lensing amplitude of one. We include foregrounds and noise, which is white noise. And we apply this to a well-known component suppression technique, which is Neatlet interlinear combination method and the Condor. So we have one expert in this group, Shobhan Basak, who developed this. So we have access to this. And this Commander pipeline is public, so we can use this component suppression technique. So for since we are interested in forecasting model for R, so we work directly for Commander. We work directly in QNU space, and before working in this, we downgrade all the maps to inside 256/60 BM resolution, so that we can directly fit the model to the data or the simulated data. So then we extract the full-on team maps and then convert to do E and B mode maps. So this is all full sky. And then we apply the mass to avoid the foreground residual, which is coming from the galactic plane region. Then we compute the cross power spectrum using Namaste code. And then we apply likelihood analysis to estimate the R. For NIL, because it works only for the scalar fields. So if we first convert to QNU maps to E and B mode maps. So for that, we work at inside 512 and 20 arcminute resolution. So we take only the B mode map. We apply the component suppression method. We mask the galactic plane region and follow the same technique that we did for Commander. So here are the results, which is important. So we so set one is the baseline model. So baseline model is we assume dust is a simple modified black body spectrum. So it's like a dust Gini template is a capturing the spatial distribution of the dust, and it is defined with a single beta and temperature. But the beta temperature is varying over the sky, as derived by Gini's algorithm. So for the simple model and for synchrotron, we take a Dalkurov model. We add CMB and noise. So in that case, so for R is equal to zero, we recover R is equal to zero. So there's no bias. That is good news. And with Commander, we get less error bar compared to NIL. So this is because Commander works in pixel space, so it get smaller error bars. For NIL, at low L, it has it returns larger error bars. So then when we add AME and not taking into account, the result does not change. So it basically means that AME is mostly concentrated in the galactic plane region, and when we are doing the analysis over the mass sky, this does not matter. We apply point sources, still there is not significant bias. So when we apply 84% delensing, we get a reduction of error bar from factor of like 50%. So it reduces by factor of 2. And our desired sensitivity is 1 times 10 to the minus 3. So this error bar is within the limit that we are targeting. But when we started including synchrotron power law or curve power law, so the NIL method is still written unbiased result. But for Commander, it start for curve power law, it is giving a biased result. So it means that it is not able to model due to the lack of low frequency coverage. So it means that in the current like the publicly available Commander, we need more low frequency channels. So this is for simple model of dust, and the highlighted colors are the box written things are with dust decorrelation. So we can see that in terms of dust decorrelation, Neatlet IC method still returns zero, like without any bias, it's consistent with zero within the error bars, but the error bars inflates to factor of 2. but commander, it is returning high bias. So which is understandable because when we are simulating and when we are fitting, it's not the same model. So that's why this reason of bias. So if it can be included in the model fitting, it can, this bias can be reduced. So this is the same plot instead of error bars. So just to show that in milk, we basically always return unbiased well with larger error bar in presence of decorrelation. For commander method, fails for curve power law, but otherwise it is consistent with zero. And in presence of dust decorrelation, it returns larger error bars. So introduce milk. So we because we are simulating, so we can propagate the error bars through noise and foregrounds. So basically, we get more foreground residuals. So 1C and 2A simulations are only difference is one include dust decorrelation and one does not include dust decorrelation. And so there is more foreground residuals and also more noise residual in this method when we're applying milk, and that leads to larger error bar on the R estimation. So this is the main result. So basically, in case of if the sky is simplistic, when foregrounds can be described with a simple modified black body spectrum or synchrotron Galbraith model, and we can fit either through blind method or unblind method, detection sensitivity of 10^-3 at 3 sigma level. From commander analysis, basically we need low frequency channels for the analysis, and dust decorrelation is basically a problem for both the methods. In one case, it increases significantly the error bars, and in other method, it introduces a large bias. So just to summarize, so the CMB experiment is still alive. It is not kicking yet, it needs a trigger. So it is continued to be a short listed project under serious consideration under ADCOS, which is Advisory Committee of Space Science. So the ISRO, they need seeks higher responsibility for a payload taken by the academic institution. So they make a committee which can explore if some of the Indian institution, they can take up some of the workload so that ISRO don't get all the burdens. So the CMB Bharat community is steadily building up with more coordinated focus and research effort for next generation CMB mission. So this is hard gestation period, but clear signs of high inspiration in ISRO. So the CMB Bharat mission presents a unique opportunity for India to take the lead in prize quest in fundamental science in the field that can improve with spectacular success. So with this, I finish my talk. Thank you.